Hi friends, do you want to master the mole? Then let's get started. In the next 10 minutes, you'll be able to define the mole, understand its application in chemistry, and solve numerical problems based on the mole. So here we go. When I tell you I have a dozen bananas, what does that mean? Yes, that means I have 12 bananas, because the word dozen means 12. We can easily weigh a dozen bananas to find out their weight. But what about atoms and molecules? Can we count a dozen atoms? How much does a dozen of atoms weigh? Atoms and molecules are so tiny that counting them in dozens is useless. So what do? Surely in chemistry, we need to know exactly how much a compound weighs, or how many atoms or molecules are involved in a reaction, or how much solute, such as glucose, is there in a solution. We need a unit that can help us estimate the number of atoms or molecules, or the amount of a substance, right? To get that unit, scientists did something really smart. They took 12 grams of carbon and experimentally determined the number of atoms in it. They found that 12 grams of carbon has 6022000 up to 20 zeros of carbon atoms. This number can be shortened to 6.022 into 10 raised to 23. Chemists take this number as a reference number and call it the Avogadro number, or Avogadro constant, in honor of Italian scientist Amedeo Avogadro. Any substance containing 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 atoms or molecules is said to be one mole. Still confused? Then all you need to remember is that the mole is just a number. Just like the word dozen, which equals 12. A mole equals 6.022 into 10 raised to 23. So if I say 1 dozen bananas, it means 12 bananas. If I say a mole of bananas, it means 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 bananas. If I say a mole of water molecules, it means 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 water molecules. Do you know how much that is? That's about 3 spoons of water weighing 18 grams. See how easy it is to express the amount of substance in moles? Here's 1 mole of glucose, which weighs 180 grams. Since it's 1 mole of glucose, we already know that it has 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 glucose molecules in it. 1 mole is thus defined as the amount of substance that contains as many entities, atoms, molecules, or other particles, as there are atoms in exactly 12 grams of carbon, which is the Avogadro number. So a mole of carbon has 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 carbon atoms. A mole of hydrogen has 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 hydrogen atoms. And so on. Now that we know what the mole is, let's put it to some use. There are 3 ways in which the mole can be helpful. We can use it to know the amount of a substance. We can use it to find out how many atoms, molecules, or entities there are in a substance. And we can use it to estimate how much of a reactant is involved in a reaction. Coming to the first application, estimation of amount of substance. Do you know how much does a mole of oxygen weigh? I know it weighs 16 grams. Do you know how much a mole of glucose weighs? I know it weighs 180 grams. How do I know that? By magic. Just kidding. I know that because of the periodic table. Let me show you how. We know from the definition of mole that 1 mole of carbon weighs 12 grams. If we look up carbon in the periodic table, we can see that its atomic mass is also 12 AMU. We can use this relationship to estimate the amount of any substance. So let's look up oxygen. Its atomic mass is 16 AMU. So 1 mole of oxygen weighs 16 grams. What about glucose? Glucose is a compound with the formula C6H12O6. Here, we need to add the individual atomic masses of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. Atomic mass of carbon is 12. Since there are 6 carbon atoms in glucose, we need to multiply this number with 6. So we get 12 into 6 equals 72 grams of carbon. Similarly, let's look up the atomic mass of hydrogen in the periodic table. It's 1. Since there are 12 hydrogens in glucose, we need to multiply this number with 12. So 1 into 12 gives 12 grams of hydrogen. Lastly, we have oxygen. Atomic mass of oxygen is 16. There are 6 oxygen atoms in glucose. So we multiply 16 and 6. We get 96 grams of oxygen. If we add up these individual masses, we get the final mass, that is 180 grams. This is also called the molar mass. So 1 mole of glucose weighs 180 grams. Can you find the mass of sodium chloride? Give it a try. Look up the atomic masses of sodium and chlorine in the periodic table, add them up, and you will get 58.5 grams. That was easy, right? Now let's move on to the second application of mole, finding out the number of atoms, molecules or entities in a substance. Let's say I have 300 grams of glucose. How many molecules of glucose will this sample have? We know from our previous calculation that 1 mole of glucose weighs 180 grams. So how many moles are there in 300 grams? Let's take that as x. If we cross multiply and solve for x, we get x equals 300 by 180 equals 1.66 moles. So we know that our sample has 1.66 moles. 1 mole has 6.022 into 10 to 23 molecules. So how many molecules does 1.66 moles of glucose have? Let's take that as x. Solving for x gives us x is equal to 1.66 into 6.022 into 10 raised to 23, which equals 9.9 into 10 raised to 23. Therefore, a sample of 300 grams of glucose has 9.9 into 10 raised to 23 molecules of glucose in it. Yay! Now we know how the mole helps in estimating amount of substance and the number of entities in a sample. We are now left with the final application of mole, which is finding out the amount of reactant involved in a reaction. This is very easy. Take any reaction, say the formation of ammonia. Nitrogen plus hydrogen gives ammonia. Balance the equation. We get N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3. The coefficients that we just added give us the amount of reactants and products in this reaction. So in the formation of ammonia, 1 mole of nitrogen is reacting with 3 moles of hydrogen to give 2 moles of ammonia. With this knowledge, my friends, you are already equipped to solve any numerical problem. Let me show you how. Solving mole-based numerical problems becomes easier if you remember this diagram. It will help you convert moles into grams and number of particles. If you look closely, this is nothing new. We have already done this while discussing the three applications of mole. This is only a shortcut to remember what we just learned. So when you convert moles into grams, simply multiply it with the atomic mass in case of atoms, or molar mass in case of molecules. For example, if you want to convert 4 moles of oxygen to grams, multiply 4 with atomic mass of oxygen, which is 16 in the periodic table. So 4 into 16 gives 64 grams. Similarly, if we are converting from grams to moles, we simply need to divide the number by the atomic mass or molar mass. Similarly, when converting from moles to number of particles, we need to multiply with Avogadro number and vice versa. Therefore, 8 moles of glucose has 8 into Avogadro number, which equals 48.1 into 10 raised to 23 molecules. How many moles is 9.9 into 10 raised to 23 molecules of glucose? Simply divide by Avogadro number when converting from number of particles to moles. So 9.9 into 10 raised to 23 divided by Avogadro number gives us 1.66 moles. That's all you need to remember, and solving any numerical problem would be a cakewalk. Now that you have mastered the mole, this quick recap will help you jog your memory. Bye-bye for now.